boys and girls of the shaft! Today, we're gonna do something a little different. Since ARK's first launch, there have been tons of animals added to the game, be them real or fantasy. We have everything from dinosaurs to acid-spitting centipedes, and from giant squids to dragons. But despite the massive variety of animals, there's always that one favorite everyone wishes would make it into the game. Well, I and our local paleontologist up from the depths have compiled a top 10 animals we'd kill to see added to ARK list thing. Some of these creatures actually existed, while some are completely made up. All right, let's go right in! Coming in at number 10, Tanistropheus! Tanistropheus was a primitive reptile dating back to the Middle Triassic period 245 million years ago, where it lived along the coastlines of Europe and Asia. These reptiles almost look like a snake crossbred with a lizard. They had these outrageously long necks with tiny heads that they would use to dive right into the water to catch fish. Now, ARK already has quite a few animals that are very well adapted to fishing, and what we know of Tanistropheus shows that it wasn't the best swimmer, but it's a very interesting looking animal that would add more variety to ARK's rocky shores and coral reefs that peep out of the oceans. Number 9! Giant crabs! I'm honestly surprised there are no crustaceans in the game. Are there? Do the sea scorpions count? Anywho, giant crabs seem like one of those B-movie monsters that fit right in with the rest of the critters that ARK has to offer. Giant 10-foot tall crabs that could be utilized as mounts for tribes early on, with the ability to scuttle all the way down to the ocean floor quickly to get resources maybe? I'm sure there's someone out there who would want a giant crab added in. Number 8, the aurochs. The aurochs is an extinct species of cattle that died out in the 16th century, giving rise to modern-day cows. They are known for having massive horns measuring nearly 3 feet in length, and all around being much larger than their modern-day counterparts. The aurochs could be integrated as a decent travel mount like the horse, but with a ramming ability that can stun small targets for several seconds. They could be made like a rare spawn like the ovis, and maybe the milk the females produce would be able to help keep baby animals fed for a long time. Maybe they could drop a special kind of meat like the ovis's mutton that would provide a benefit, be it making an animal tame faster or quickly recovering any lost HP on your mount, provided that it's a carnivorous one, of course. Number 7! An underwater boss leviathan. It's been rumored, but never confirmed, that an underwater boss fight may come into the game. I have a suspicion that it will most likely come in a future DLC. A user in one of Wildcard's past Q&As gave a pretty awesome idea of an ocean boss being accessible via a lost obelisk, sunken beneath the waves of ARK's oceans. This is also useful for players that have giant water pens of aquatic animals that aren't being used, especially those on PvE. Now, as for the Leviathan itself, I imagine it to be a hybrid of every awful thing ARK's waterways have to offer, from giant tentacles grabbing you to massive toothed jaws that will finish the job. The Tussotoothus is already pretty freaky looking, so I imagine it's gonna be pretty hard to top that. Number 6! Brachiosaurus! Brachiosaurus is an A-list dinosaur like your T-Rexes and Triceratopses. Everyone recognizes its iconic silhouette with large forelimbs and its head held high in the air. Brachiosaurus was a humongous species of sauropod dinosaur from late Jurassic North America about 153 million years ago. A little fun fact for you guys. Most depictions of Brachiosaurus you see are actually of whatever the hell this thing is. I'm not gonna bother trying to pronounce it. Fuck you, Depths. A related species from Africa. It was concluded that the original Brachiosaurus remains found in Tanzania were much too different than Brachiosaurus itself, so it was placed in its own genus. It's kind of disappointing that the largest herbivorous dinosaurs in the game can't actually do damage to stone structures, despite being some of the strongest dinosaurs to have existed. I was never a fan of the Giga. It was made way too big and powerful, and given the role of a siege dino, didn't sit right with me. I'd love to see the role of a siege dino given to Brachiosaurus with a powerful front stomp attack with those massive legs dealing crushing damage to stone structures and potentially crushing any mounts caught underfoot. Its tall neck could support a ladder-like structure for tribes to scale walls with ease, turning this sauropod into a living siege tower. Coming in at number 5, the Gorgonopsid. This is an animal that is amongst the top requested whenever you look at the forums. Gorgonopsids were primitive mammal-like reptiles that thrived in the Permian era about 265 million years ago. Gorgonopsids varied in size from a meter in length to 11 feet tall. Their appearance is like if you took a tiger and covered it in scales instead of fur. Although some reconstructions of Gorgonopsids are shown with fur too, given that these animals are the ancestors of mammals. You're more closely related to a Gorgonopsid on the evolutionary tree than you are to a T-Rex. Ha! How about that? Now, these are some badass prehistoric animals, but how would they be incorporated into the game? I imagine Wildcard would incorporate Gorgonopsids, similarly to the Thylacoleo, giving it the ability to climb vertical surfaces. Gorgonopsids were known to have pronounced canines like a saber tooth. Maybe they could be used as a sort of sabotage dino where their bite can drain HP or stamina. I'm actually pretty surprised that these guys didn't make the cut originally. Number 4, even bigger scorpions. Scorpions are pretty cool arachnids. Bigger scorpions are even cooler. While Clash of the Titans wasn't an incredible movie, it had some awesome special effects and art direction. And what I'll always remember is the caravan of giant scorpions moving along the desert. Scorpions so big that they had actual houses built upon them. The current scorpions are really cool, but I wish they were bigger. I'm actually very surprised there exists no mod for something like this. Unless I'm mistaken. Number 3! A huge, rideable desert spider! Let's be honest, does anyone actually tame the current spiders in ARK? They're not very exciting and kinda suck at their job. Plus, they can't even climb walls. They aren't all that unique looking either. They pretty much resemble any generic spider from every video game that decided to include spiders as enemies. So what about a rideable tarantula-looking spider that has evolved on scorched earth to be the size of a Carnotaurus and is capable of several interesting tricks? They could function as somewhat of a support role, spinning walls of silk that would block off choke points from an oncoming attack, or even escaping a deadly enemy through the narrow ravines like the ones in Scorched Earth. Some spiders will bury themselves and create a trapdoor mechanism that would trap enemy players or small mounts that venture too close, sort of like the Perlovia's burrowing ability. Oh, and let's throw in the ability to scale walls for good measure. These giant desert spiders would be an incredibly interesting and absolutely terrifying addition to the game that would make the current cave spiders pale in comparison. Coming in at number 2, Kaiju, aka giant monsters for all you non-weebs out there. Up From the Depths is throwing this one in here because he's a huge Godzilla nerd. Seriously, have you guys ever seen his desk? Look at this fucking nerd. Now, there's no way Wildcard could get Godzilla officially into the game without breaking copyright laws. But Studio Wildcard's artists and animators would have no trouble at all creating their own. Now, we already have our own monsters in ARK to deal with, like Titanosaurus, Gigas, bosses themselves, but the former can be easily dispatched using various methods. There needs to be a force of nature that you unfortunately cannot prepare for. A massive monster that would rise out of the ocean, that would wander around aimlessly across the map, then returning back to the depths as quickly as it arrived, would be one hell of a sight, and a major pain in the ass for any alpha tribes whose bases were unfortunately caught in its path. This would also help literally leveling the playing field every so often so servers wouldn't become stagnant with one alpha tribe reigning dominant over everyone else. And finally, number 1! A race of NPCs! I bet this was the last thing people were expecting for the number 1 slot. I feel that PvE and single player survivals need more of a challenge, and PvP players could use something to shake things up a bit. So let's throw in some NPCs. What kind though? Well, there's a bunch of different ones, so let's go through them. They could go the easy route and add in survivors that wouldn't stand out compared to the other players. Some of them could be hostile, some could be friendly, and you could ally with them and trade goods. It would add an interesting RPG element to the game to gain a tribe of NPCs' trust. The Bush People mod has this covered, I suppose. Prehistoric Neanderthals would be cool to come across in the snow biome. Maybe even earlier hominids like Australopithecines. Or how about we get a little freakier? One of the coolest reveals I've seen in video games in a long time was the completely unannounced introduction of aliens into a game called Elite Dangerous. Only very few players have encountered them, and the existence of aliens in the game had been just a legend up until now. I just think wandering around the woods in ARK at night and coming across aliens would be the coolest and scariest thing ever. Especially if nobody knew they were added into the game. Hey Wildcard, if you're watching, this is a great idea and I hope to see you implement it. Unless you are. And I may have just totally spoiled a big surprise you guys had. Don't hurt Depths, I swear he didn't know. Well, that wraps up today's video. Comment below, what do you think of our proposed critters? And do you have any more? Come chat about it in the Shaft Discord or with other players on our very own Light RP server. Be sure to subscribe and smash that like button! Later!